I have memorized the faces of all of our security officers.
I am Nicholas Klar. Welcome to Sinbot Studios.
Louisa Lieb.
Nationality?
Austrian.
Two thieves, each with his hands so entangled in the other man's pocket that they cannot separately plunder a third.
A guy came to visit us one day. He was a journalist from Pravda, which was a very big newspaper run by the government in Moscow, but based in New York. He was a New York correspondent. And he came on the set. He said, "Mr. Landau, how do you do? I want to say I watch your show all the time. Very good. I have a 12-year-old son who's a very big fan of your show.
Yes, he destroyed my fires.
I let him stay up Sunday nights to watch your show. But it's very embarrassing. My son,
certification number.
Sunday nights I let him stay up late to watch your show. But he says, hi, Pop, how come all the bad guys talk like you?
I heard a great deal about you. You are very kind.
The ministry has arranged for a screening for the representatives of the world press of your film, the Swiss legation, day after tomorrow.
Good. Excellent.
I understand this brilliant project is entirely your creation.
His son had grown up here. He had been living here for a long enough time. And he was always explaining to his son that on our show he was the bad guy. Well, I said, be as good a guy as you can, and then he'll have to see that you're not such a bad guy.
And he said, why are you using, always you're not naming, but you're using Russian accent. What is this you're doing? You are teasing us, or you're aggressor, or something. I said, I don't know anything about that. That script said that we were in Ruritania. Now, the accent might be similar. I don't know. So we had fun with those things.
It was a lot of galleries, yeah. It was, you know, and never police. It was police, or palazzi, or police, you know.
Out!
It was recognizably wrongly spelled. And, you know, cabaret was spelled improperly, or circus had the wrong, you know, everything looked like an eye chart. We never went anywhere either. I mean, we went to Pasadena City Hall, or the furthest, we went to the desert one time to do a Western show.
Had a lot, two men tried to kill me, took my horses.
What did these men look like?
Two Americanos. Big men. An officer in a uniform like yours. A colonel.
Some water for this man.
We went to Malibu Lake, and I mean, we never left Los Angeles. And we were, you know, basically all over the world on that show, and never anywhere. So, I mean, to think that we shot that entire series in these exotic foreign countries, never leaving Los Angeles.
You may remember that computers were really just beginning to come in when we did that show.
And run this through data control. Correct the cost per item to 3.5. I think that will take care of the problem.
It seems to me that we started that show, and I started the show, to do all these quick, obtain these secrets or identities of people and so forth. We were using that IBM machine with cards in it, you know?
Clean up the mess. I'll get a serviceman over here right away.
And then we finally graduated to the tape recorder, and that was, God, that was a lot of fun. Because people always wanted to know how we did that. And they said, geez, the tape self-destructs and the smoke comes out of the tape and everything.
This recording will self-destruct in 10 seconds. Good luck, Jim.
I said, that's because we didn't let you see that the prop man is down on the floor under the table with a tube and a cigarette. And then they thought that was marvelous, you know. And it was. I shouldn't be telling secrets like that.
Ah, that's great, Barney. Good. What about his Moroccan passport?
We were all experts in certain areas and were called on to exhibit our expertise, and other lives are at stake continually. So our team and our camaraderie is something that was, the fact that we liked each other as actors also kind of bled into the reality of the show.
It thrived on the idea of appearances. What something appeared, I have a uniform on, I have a badge, I have a certain hat on, or my truck says so-and-so. And that gave us access. Like it was real, you know. So there was a lot, if you put a nurse's uniform on, patient let you give them a lethal injection, you know. So appearances were kind of an interesting aspect of what Bruce was dealing with.
Bruce's ideas were quite strict about what he wanted to see on the screen. And I remember the very first mission I did, as we conquered the villains and saw them being taken away by the police, and we passed by them, I let the slightest smile just crease one side of my face. The next day, Bruce Geller was down on the set saying, "Don't editorialize." How's that? Walk away. Do the deed. Walk away. Okay, that's done. Don't editorialize. We were always very grateful that he was sitting up there in the office every day and well on into the evening trying to figure out the next show.
Was very clear about what he was doing. And that was an incredibly comforting feeling to know that. That in essence, we were in good hands.
You were yourself to start with, and then you dressed up and played other characters, older, younger, different dialects, you know, German. Ach so, you know, you play a German.
I will receive them now.
Next week, a Russian fellow who talks like this, or a gangster, you know, hey, Charlie, you know, you never know what the heck you're going to be singing and how you're going to say it, you know what I mean? So it gave you a kind of field day as an actor.
Since you insist.
Well, I did a fight sequence in a warehouse and a show called A Spool There Was with Warren Vanders, who was light heavyweight champion of the United States Army at one point. And we did much of it ourselves with crowbars and barrels and stuff. And it's a long fight sequence, and I'd say more than three quarters of it were the two of us. And I trusted him and he trusted me. So, you know, I mean, with crowbars, I mean, you swing and duck and swing again and duck. You don't want to get hit with one of those.
It was a very difficult filmic show. And you spent a lot of time in each one watching somebody's hands doing something, stealing a diamond or unscrewing a thing and connecting a couple of wires. So we learned very early on that we had to establish a second unit crew so that we didn't have to photograph all of those things during our regular schedule of shooting the show.
And people were always kind of doing that when they met me. They said, "Is that really you?" You know, and because I had a particular way of appealing it. I didn't do that. I sort of lifted it from the side. The show was fun. We had a good time. We liked each other. The actors really enjoyed each other. I played an astonishing plethora of characters on that show, and all kinds of, you know, dialects.
It was a field day, actually a field day. I had a very good time, you know. I enjoyed it. immensely.
The fun of it was that I got to play somebody different each week, as well as Jim Phelps. If I had to seduce a European princess in Ruritania or wherever, that was the fun of doing it, to be able to carry that off and leave a tear in the princess's eye at the end of the show. Always seducing is a lot of fun. Jeez. We did a wonderful show with Joan Collins, who was our guest one then. She was a beautiful Ruthenian princess. And it was my job to disguise as a military officer and try to win her. And we succeeded, and what our real job was to get her out of the country to safety and allow certain things to happen there that that we didn't want to happen. As we're finally taking her out of the country, and we've evaded all the hound dogs and everything else, but they find us and they shoot her and kill her. And she dies in my arms, and I had a tear in my eye that time.
I had the fun of all these unusual people who were either jailed or getting away with all kinds of things and different accents. And
boys, I know I have heard it before when I was young. Something terrible was happening.
Different ruses, you know, different playing a trapeze artist and not really being one, and all kinds of wonderful things. They were great fun, no question.
And by golly, they were well done, yeah, if I do say so. So I consider that a very fortunate thing to have done in a career.
By the way, I always wanted to take a mask off and have the same face underneath.